Hello and welcome. You're with IndiaPostLive.com, India's first live interactive web television. Well, on the 13th of November, the day before World Diabetes Day, we had done a show on the bariatric surgery and how it is picking up in India and how it is helping certain people with type 2 diabetes as well. You will remember that heavyweight politician Arun Jaitley got that surgery done a while ago, and he lost as much as 17 kilos. Now, what exactly is the surgery all about? What are the pros? What are the cons? We had tried to give you some information on the 13th in our show, but today, to tell us, you know, in greater detail to laymen like you and me, I have with me online Dr. Deep Goel. Dr. Deep Goel is the head of GI and bariatric surgery from BLK Hospital in New Delhi, and he joins us online to give us some more information about bariatric surgery. Sir, welcome to IndiaPostLive.com, and thank you so much for speaking to us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Okay, sir, before we begin, I would just like to, you know, just to refresh and remind our viewers, run you through a couple of graphics, which I will also be reading out, so you can correct me if I go wrong there. Basically, what is bariatric surgery all about and who all can go in for this surgery? Let's take a look at those graphics first, coming up on your screens right now. So bariatric surgery, what is bariatric surgery? Essentially a weight loss, which is achieved by stomach size reduction. The journey of the food is cut down by 2/3. It does not allow sugar buildup. And if you can manage to regulate your diet, there is no weight gain for as much as 10 years. What are the methods of reducing the stomach size? Gastric band, removal of a portion of the stomach, or resecting and rerouting small intestines to the stomach pouch, also called gastric bypass surgery. All right, so that is what bariatric surgery essentially is. Let us understand it a bit more clearly from Dr. Goel. Sir, bariatric surgery, why should one do a bariatric surgery in the first place?
Your voice is not clear at all. I cannot understand. What question have you asked?
Dr. Goel, what is bariatric surgery and who should go in for a bariatric surgery? Can you hear me now?
No.
Okay, we'll try and I'll try and repeat my question to you. So, can you give us some details about bariatric surgery?
Okay, let me just explain. Is my voice clear?
Absolutely clear. Absolutely clear, sir. Please go ahead.
Okay, I will tell you, because I can't hear what you're saying, but I get a feeling. Bariatric surgery is a surgery where we, by laparoscopy, we make certain arrangements inside the stomach so the eating capacity of a person is reduced drastically, and he or she is able to eat only a very small amount of meat at a time.
Okay.
Also, there are a lot of neurohormonal changes which happen during surgery and after surgery, which lead to not only weight loss, but control of diabetes, control of high blood pressure, control of bad cholesterol, control of infertility, control of arthritis like knee joints, backache, control of infertility, as I said, and there is enough evidence today that it also reduces the chances of cancer, chances of heart attack, chances of kidney diseases, chances of stroke. So practically, whatever diseases which we are aware of, the chances of them are reduced drastically in people who undergo bariatric surgery and lose weight.
All right.
In other words, obesity is the main culprit where all these diseases are seen much more common as compared to a person who is not obese. When we talk about cancer in women, breast, uterus, ovary, kidney, colon, thyroid, all these cancers are much more common in people who are obese. In men, food by stomach, rectum, pancreas, kidney are much more common in people who are obese. So this is a huge statement where we are saying after tobacco, obesity is the second commonest preventable cause of cancer in the body. And India has been declared as a world capital of obesity and diabetes by 2030 in a survey done by WHO.
Right. Okay.
It is our duty as responsible citizens to make sure that we do not let this happen.
All right. So let me just, graphically, try and represent what, Dr. Goel told us right now. Who all can go in for this surgery? People who are obese, that is people who have a BMI of over 33. These are the people who can go in for the bariatric surgery. Women who are overweight, who are unable to conceive, who have irregular menstrual cycles, patients suffering from type 2 diabetes. Now, these are the people who can definitely must opt for a bariatric surgery. All right. Now, as the doctor told us, what are the benefits of this surgery? What does it do? Of course, essentially, it cuts down weight. But as a result of that, it controls type 2 diabetes. It controls various types of cancers, improvement in cardiovascular factors. There is a possible reduction of mortality resulting from all these obesity-related issues from 23% to 23% from 40%. Dr. Goel, we have already, like you told us, diabetes is, a killer and it's a lifestyle disease in India. Can you hear me?
Yeah, your voice again breaking, yeah. But I think what we are talking about is indications of surgery and how it helps.
Okay, you can talk to us about that. I was asking you about diabetes,
yeah.
But you can talk to us about that, yeah.
How we calculate obesity is a formula called body mass index,
yeah.
BMI.
Right.
It is very simple to calculate by weight in kilograms divided by height in meter square. So normal BMI is 18-23. Anybody who has a BMI of more than 32 with any of the illnesses which we just described,
yeah,
like diabetes, arthritis, heart problem, sleep apnea, whatever, they are likely candidate who will benefit from surgery. And anybody who has a BMI of more than 35 without any illness are also the candidate for surgery.
All right. So would you say that the number of people who are opting for bariatric surgery is on the rise in India?
Yes.
Why is that?
Anybody who has BMI more than 32.5 with diabetes, with osteoarthritis or sleep apnea, hypertension, bad cholesterol, they are candidate for surgery.
All right. Let's take a look at the bariatric surgery scenario in India. Now, that is steadily on the rise. More and more people are opting for the surgery because, as the doctor told you, diabetes, definitely India is the diabetes capital of the world. Unfortunately, there are a million deaths per year in India because of diabetes. And bariatric surgeries in India, more and more people are opting for it. There are 1,800 bariatric operations per month, mostly in high-end private hospitals. So, Dr. Goel, if you can hear me, a question I wanted to ask you is that bariatric surgery is not covered by insurance, am I right? So only people with deep pockets can opt for the surgery, is it not?
Yes, I think the insurance sector, the private insurance sector has not yet recognized this surgery to be reimbursable. But good news is that central government has recognized this surgery not as a cosmetic surgery, but a life-saving surgery, which not only reduces the chances of diseases which we have discussed, but also it prolongs life after surgery.
Right.
So all the central government employees can undergo this surgery at a CGHS approved center, which our team is approved at the moment, and government reimburses them. So that's a very good news. I think, as you rightly said, the next step is going to be that insurance companies have to accept this in a couple of years. We are fighting with them very fiercely, making representation from all bodies involved in this particular operation. And we have made some inroads, and I'm sure in very soon.
Right. Now, you know, as you know,
we would be able to convince Jai.
Right. Because the cost of the surgery is 2 to 3.5 lakh rupees, is it not? That's a huge cost.
Yes, cost is roughly 2.5 lakhs. I would request you not to look at it as a 2.5 lakh cost.
Hmm.
You must look at it, suppose we are not doing this surgery and person has diabetes, person has heart disease, person has kidney disease, any one of them. Each of these diseases are killers in themselves. Imagine a person undergoing treatment for kidney disease like dialysis. How much does it cost? How many hours are lost from work? Similarly, if stenting has to be done or a surgery has to be done for heart disease, how much work loss and how much finances are lost?
Right.
And mind you, this surgery is done by minimal invasive technique. There is no big incision on the belly. It's only small punctures in the belly. Person goes home in 2 days' time and back to work in 5 to 7 days' time.
Great.
It's
all right.
Right.
Right. Let me, you know, we were planning to do the show, like I said, on the eve of World Diabetes Day. Let me just present some statistics on diabetes to our viewers before we go on, because I want to ask you the cosmetic surgery angle also. Okay, like I told you just a while ago, India is the diabetes capital of the world, and more people are dying every year. 1 million people die from this disease. Now, if you can see, you know, the International Journal of Diabetes in developing countries tells us that in 2004, 37 million people were affected in India, and that figure increased to 41 million in 2007. But by the time it becomes 2030, there will be 89 million people affected by diabetes. Diabetes, 1 in 6 people in India suffer from diabetes. That is the sad reality of this disease. And 1 million people, as I was saying, die every year due to diabetes. 1 in 6, of course, it is a lifestyle disease. It is also a genetic disease. The best way is, you know, exercise and control of diet. And the last recourse, as Dr. Goel was telling us, is bariatric surgery that helps in a lot of ways to control. But Dr. Goel, I also want to ask you, you know, if one were to compare, say, a liposuction to a bariatric surgery, if you talk of the weight loss, of course, cancers, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, definitely. But as a weight loss option, should one go only weight loss option? Should one go for bariatric or a liposuction?
Well, let me clarify, liposuction is not a weight loss surgery.
Okay.
It is the biggest myth which people have.
Right, right.
Liposuction is a contouring surgery. What it means, if people in the glamour world or of that age, have certain part of their body where they have more fat as compared to rest of the body, like lower abdomen or thighs, upper thighs or arms, that is where you can do liposuction to get that part in symmetry with other part of the body.
Okay.
And you can lose couple of inches, not many kilos. You are likely to lose 3 to 5 kilos in one time.
Okay.
But that weight always comes back in very short period. However, the inches may remain there. That is why we call it a contouring surgery, and should not be confused with weight loss surgery.
Lovely. I think that was a great piece of information that we got from the doctor, that Liposuction is not a weight loss surgery. It is only a contouring surgery. It is more cosmetic in nature. You can lose inches, you can lose some kilos, but the weight always has a way of getting back on your body. All right, great. Thank you so much. And sir, can we also ask you, every surgery there are complications, every surgery there are adverse effects. The fact that you're cutting down the size of the stomach, what about nutritional deficiency related adverse effects that can occur through bariatric surgery? Can you take us through those as well?
Yes, I think we must understand whenever you're doing any procedure on the body, it will carry some complications. If anybody says that a particular procedure is 100% safe, I don't think they're doing justice to the patient.
Right.
One has to be very transparent about any complications which can happen. So whenever you are cutting any part of the body and sewing it, there can be bleeding from that part, there can be leakage of fluid from that part. These are two commonest complications. But again, we have to keep in mind the incidence of these complications is in single digit, is around 1 to 2%.
Okay.
Also, one must understand that these obese people, I'm talking about people who are 150 kilos, 160 kilos, their immunity is also low. Sometimes it is possible accidentally to have infection.
Right.
But that is why it is important to have these surgeries in a renowned center by trained doctors, not to be done in a smaller centers where all the facilities are not available. It might sound sometimes very lucrative due to cost to get done in the centers where all the facilities are not available or the team is not properly trained. But believe me, that is not the way it should be done, because ultimately what you are doing, this surgery is to make a person healthier.
Right. Absolutely.
We would like to minimize complications closer to the zero. We always compare our specialty to civil aviation. Imagine you go for a plane ride and you die in an accident. So accidents can happen anywhere, but we would like the safety measures of our specialty to be almost zero.
All right, great, great. Thank you. Of course, like the doctor said, that every surgery, there are risks of complications. Every surgery, there are certain risks that go with it. And the most important thing is to ensure that you have a good team of surgeons who are conducting the surgery on you. You're going to a good hospital where there are, when it comes to sterilization measures, when it comes to basic surgical equipment and all of that, there is absolutely no lacunae when it comes to any of that. So let's take a look graphically at some of the points that the doctor told us regarding what could possibly go wrong in a bariatric surgery, though the number is very small. Coming up on your screens right now, the adverse effects: gastric dumping syndrome, bloating and diarrhea after eating, necessitating small meals or medication, leaks at the surgical site, sir was just telling us about the bleeding, incisional hernia, infections, definitely if you're not going to a good hospital, pneumonia. There could be an adverse effect on kidneys. Some people have reported that. Metabolic bone disease, osteopenia, secondary hyperparathyroidism, increased risk of fracture due to reduced calcium absorption. There could also be nutritional derangements due to deficiencies of micronutrients like iron, vitamin B12. And some fat-soluble vitamins like thiamine and folate. Now, there is a very, very little mortality rate of 0.2% only. But of course, it is after all a surgery, and on this, operating table, things could go wrong. Yeah, please go ahead, doctor. Please go ahead.
I think a lot of these complications you have listed, like pneumonia, like osteoporosis, these are common side effects which can happen in any surgery.
Right.
And they are particularly to the bariatric surgery. We definitely counsel these patients about the kind of diet they need to take after the surgery.
Absolutely.
If they are compliant, if they follow the instructions, these complications would not normally occur. That's why I said that these surgeries should be done in renowned centers where we have all facilities looking after the patient care.
Absolutely. So, you know, post-operative care is as important as the surgical procedure itself, because after all, you are tampering with a certain part of the body. So one has to take nutritional supplements, I suppose. Am I not right?
Absolutely. We have a specialized bariatric nutritionist in our department who not only counsels patients before operation, but also after operation, to minimize all these complications of malnutrition or osteoporosis in these patients.
So my last question to you, sir, you said that you are fighting a battle to ensure that bariatric surgery is not treated like a cosmetic surgery. It is treated as a regular surgery, which is curing lifestyle related and very, very grave illnesses like cancer, like diabetes, like a lot of cardiovascular diseases, and also hormonal imbalances. Are you saying that 2 years later, if you win the fight, the number per year, the number of surgeries, bariatric surgeries per year will increase manifold once the insurance comes into the picture?
Absolutely. I think when, you know, when I was being trained in England in 1998 and I came back to India, when we started doing the surgeries, we're doing around 200 cases in a year in whole country.
Oh, God.
Today, we are doing more than 15,000 cases in a year in the whole country, and they are growing very fast. Now we do a huge number of patients in a month, and there is in fact a waiting list for these patients to undergo surgery. And I expect these numbers to go drastically up in next 5 years.
All right, all right. Thank you so much, Dr. Goel. It was great having you on the show. In fact, like I told you earlier, we had only presented some facts, but we wanted a specialist perspective from you. Thank you so much for taking out time to talk to us and give us that perspective on our portal. Thank you so much. It was great having you. So all of you there.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. So all of you there, all the information that you needed about bariatric surgery coming straight from the doctor. He's the director of bariatric and GI surgery at BLK Hospital, Dr. Deep Goel. He took out time for his very, very busy and hectic schedule just to talk to us on IndiaPostLive.com. Thank you so much. We will wrap up the show now. If all of you have any questions, please send it across to us. We will also send it to Dr. Goel and he can answer your queries through IndiaPostLive.com. You can send us your posts, your comments, your feedback. If you have undergone the surgery and if you have some experiences to share, please do that as well. You can also tweet us at @IndiaPostLive and #IndiaPostLive. Thank you all so much for watching. I do hope that this show has cleared your mind of a lot of doubts that you might have had, a lot of questions that you might have had about bariatric surgery. Thank you so much, all of you, for watching. Thank you, doctor.